welcome to Talk Techy to Me. My name's Brooke.
And I'm Mark.
And today we're going to talk about Lockheed Martin innovations.
Our guest today is Tom Warner, Lockheed Martin's Vice President of Cyber Solutions. So Tom, I was reading the other day about the convergence of cyber and electronic warfare. Can you tell us more about what that means and, you know, how it relates to armed forces?
Sure. I mean, today's battlefield is different. While it's necessary that we dominate air, land, sea, space, we also need to dominate the RF spectrum. And that's where you have communications, that's where you have navigation and timing, that's where you also have your mobile communication networks. And so if you think about communication that happens in the battlefield, you have your soldier needs to contact another soldier or communicate with aircraft or aircraft to satellite, satellite to ground or ground to the operators and then back to the soldiers again. And all of that happens over RF. So it's important for our armed forces to dominate that spectrum to make sure that our communications can always get through. And cyber and electronic warfare, when you bring those together, the cyber techniques, electronic warfare capabilities, that allows us to deny or otherwise alter the capabilities that our enemies have in those spaces so that we can ultimately have a warfighting advantage.
So you told us a little bit about the military category of cyber. Are there other types of cyber we should be aware of?
Sure, I think there's two main categories of cyber, and maybe cyber threats that we should be aware of. One is the advanced persistent threats. These are well-funded nation-state actors focused on really stealing data from the U.S. government and industry. And sometimes even they go as far as not only to steal the data, but either to alter it or otherwise destroy the data on our networks. The other category that I would consider to be non-advanced persistent threats really are criminals. People that will put ransomware on your computer and then make you click on that link to then pay them money so they will unlock your computer so you can get your data back. It's a terrible thing, including identity theft and things of that nature. It's all about monetizing this from a kind of a criminal perspective. So these are the things that we need to be aware of and really actively defend against.
Speaking of being aware of, what are some of the trends we should be aware of?
One is the Internet of Things, all of the devices that are in your homes that are internet connected and unfortunately aren't always developed in the most secure way, which then potentially represents vulnerabilities or ways for the bad guys and girls to get into your home network. So you have to be careful of that. Secondly, as we think about DoD, one of our major customers, they are focused on getting their arms around weapon system cybersecurity and making sure that those weapon systems are resilient from a cyber perspective. And I would expect to see more policy, regulation, and focus in that area.
Well, Tom, you have effectively convinced me to change all my passwords, if I can remember them. And thank you for coming to the show. We really appreciated having you come on.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us as well. We want you to talk techie with us. So leave your comments and questions below. You might see them in a future episode.
Bye, guys.
See ya.